we're Scrappy.
I'm Melissa, and this is Eve. Welcome to our channel.
And this is Scrappy Sew and So. I'm totally keeping that in. Jazz hands and all.
We're getting more jazzy.
Yeah, confetti. Yeah. I was watching the, whatchamacallit, on YouTube, the Tula Pink Bill. I was trying to, but my family was making fun of it. I'm a loser.
They made fun. My family made fun of me too. Can you turn that down? What is this?
Yeah, so it was Tula Pink on the Fat Quarter Shop, and every 5 minutes or every 5 seconds they had confetti coming down. So if I can figure out how to do that, I'll pop it in. So we have a short episode today. We're both pretty tired. We're knackered.
It's a weeknight.
Yeah, I had my first day of semester two today, so I did nothing but talk all day, so.
Oh, no.
Might not talk so much tonight. That's okay, no, it's so anything for scrappiness. So we're just going to talk a little bit about Melissa's block yet to finish her OJ.
I'm on my last one, and it's a monster. But I think it looks pretty.
It does look really good. You've really got that monster under control. In fact, your back looks so much better than mine. My back is, like, hairy. It's like, not my real back. My husband's back is hairy. My real back is not hairy, but my back of that block is like, it's craziness. It's craziness in fabric.
I've been working on it slowly, but.
Yeah, but we've had a busy start to 2020, especially you, right? Because Melissa is redecorating her kitchen.
Yeah.
So she's mid-kitchen reno. For all of you people out there that are doing it, you know.
It's a nightmare. But it's coming along.
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying not to be like it's a nightmare. But I took my vacation because it's like it was Bob's birthday and now it's my birthday in a couple days. So I always take this time off, although we just don't really go anywhere. But at least not having to like
deal with work
and being like having no real kitchen. But I've just been cleaning the house and I washed walls today and I was like, at the dinner table, I was like, if I see anyone's feet on the walls, I can't be held responsible. Blake's just like,
is that the like repeat offender with feet on the wall?
No.
Oh, you?
It's Bob. I'm sitting in the living room, but he'll be sitting on the couch and I'll look over and his feet just be on the wall, and I'm like,
So I was like texting Melissa last night saying, you know, we're gonna look back and say, hey, remember when you renoed the kitchen?
Yeah.
And we'll laugh about it because it'll be like, you know, ancient history.
Can't wait.
But right now you have to live in it, so
it's fine. It could be worse.
I've been spending my catch-up month. I had maybe some wild and crazy desires to start stashing. Didn't happen. I was thinking about maybe starting the triangles because they're making me lose sleep. But didn't happen either. I was playing around with the Frolic quilt from Bonnie Hunter. So I was doing that actually yesterday. We were going to film a video yesterday, but the weather was kind of bad, so I didn't want to drive because I get a little anxious about driving in snow.
Yeah.
So that's what I did is I played around with the design. I put it into EQE, and then I like made some more pinwheels. I got to make 36 blocks. I shouldn't be talking about how many blocks are in it, so I'm not going to tell you how many blocks Bonnie had in it, but I'm going to make mine with 36 blocks, so it's a decent size, and then I'm going to curse myself while I'm trying to quilt it.
Were you trying to change it so that, like, you could do on diagonal but not, like, lose half a block?
No, I don't care for the diagonal, so I'm just doing it straight up, and then that way I'm not cutting off any fabric, because fabric is precious. We all know that, right? Fabric is precious.
Yeah, I usually have that feeling, but then while I've been trying to reorganize and clean up, I'm like, oh my god, I have so much fabric. I gotta just start making things.
What am I saving these scraps for?
Well, not even the scraps. Like, I have like 3 yards of each of the different colors of the squirrels from All Stars from Tulip Pink, and I'm like, why do I not have grocery bags made out of these so I can like have them
and use the fabric
and use them?
Yeah.
And then I was saving them for backings before, but then I bought the free fall, like the wide back.
So 3 yards doesn't do a good size back either, right?
No.
Like it's, you'd have to combine them and that.
I don't know what I was thinking, but that, I don't usually buy that much. Like usually I'm like, if I buy a meter or a yard, it's like, that's like the most that I usually buy or something, but.
Yeah.
That was when we went to Ottawa.
Oh, right. Well, it was fresh then, right? It just
came
out.
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah, and we just, like, saw tulip pink.
Yeah, so we were, like, living in the moment.
And she was in the store.
Yeah, we got to shop with her. Remember that? I wish someone else was coming back so we could go on a road trip, a quilty road trip. Because I look back on that with fondness, even though we were tired as hell. Like,
oh, yeah. It was so worth it, though. It was so worth it.
So worth it. Okay, well, for picking a winner, we got to pick a winner for the catch-up month, right? So it wasn't a particular block or row this month. It was just a catch-up, right?
Whatever row you hadn't made.
Yeah, help you to take off some resolutions, get caught up with Dear Jane. So do you want to pick the winner?
Sure. I got row I finished, and I got... row J almost finished. This is the last one. So
before we actually pick it, let's just look at the prize actually, because we should do that. Because Melissa made this and it is absolutely gorgeous. And oh my God, look at, she used Zuma on the inside, and this is like my favorite print from Zuma. It's my favorite so much I bought the leggings. So I have these leggings, and I actually wore them to work last week when there were no students. But so it's got like 3 pockets on the inside. It's got a little hook there so you can clip your scissors on if you want to, right? There's a needle.
Yeah, it's a little wool patch to put your needles in. And it's kind of like a needle book, but just like one layer. And a little
pincushion. Yeah, it's got...
Yeah.
Walnuts and lavender.
Yeah, it's the lavender scented ground.
It's
walnut.
Delicious. I know you can't smell it from where you are, but like this is like a quality bag. And look at, we love this tulip pink colors. We really do. So
it's the pattern is the Sew Together bag by Sew Demented. And that's really awesome. And when I was looking, the directions always confuse me. For like almost every single thing that is like 3D.
Yeah.
If it's just like a quilt, like I can totally understand it, but something 3D that you have to make like a bag, I'm just lost. So I watched some of the YouTube videos, and then I was seeing they have like a little bag that you can put in it into one of the little things.
So like put like your EPP or...
Well, it's like they had, I don't remember what she had in it, but it like fits right in between those two bags. Like it just is a little insert. And then, and I also saw like they had a little clip, like a little bag, a little bowl kind of thing to put clips. So I was like, oh, that would be amazing. But I don't have another month to like figure out all of those pieces to make it. So, but I mean, somebody can add them to their own bag.
Exactly. And you can still get the Zuma fabric.
Oh, yeah.
So here, I'll shake it out. There's a few more winners this time, or opportunities to be winners, because a couple people finished more than one row, right? And yeah, because it was catch-up month. So drum roll. I can't do that. And I'm really tired. There you go.
Okay. I got one. Who was it? Oh, Quilts Eventually.
Quilts Eventually.
This is a first-time winner.
First-time winner. Ding, ding, ding. I just put that
up. I thought for sure it was going to be Sonic again.
Yeah, Sonic had 2 entries in there. So, you're probably doing a poster before I get the video up. I probably won't get the video up till tomorrow night. So,
I started it.
We'll post it on Instagram. You'll see it before you see the video, but that's okay.
And we're moving on to row K.
And we're moving on to row K. So for the row K prize, like as I was leaving the house tonight, I had a bunch of stuff to bring with me to Melissa's, and I totally forgot to bring the bag that I made for row K for February. So what I will do is I will put a photo of it on top of our talking when I get home and I edit the video. And This one is an inside outside pouch by Anila Hui. I had to make one for a swap, which I haven't sent yet, so I made two. I mean, you might as well, right?
Nice.
If you're cutting one, you might as well cut two. So I made two. It has a really nice spot on both sides with a piece of vinyl so you can put thread in the side. I like it because then I know what colors where, etc.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's a really good big gusset pouch on the inside, which you can put like
nice. Gusset.
Gusset. I like saying that word, gusset. So there's a nice little pouch on the inside that you can store your other stuff in that maybe you don't want everyone to see. And maybe I'll throw in a couple bits of Wonderfill because I have some new Wonderfill that I haven't opened. So I'll throw that in there too so you can try out the Wonderfill because I've been using that sometimes for my Dear Jane block. Yeah, and that'll show you where the thread goes, I guess. So I will put a photo up of the video
cool.
when I start editing. So what you need to do for Roquet is finish all the blocks.
Roquet.
Yep, post them.
All in the same post.
Add the hashtag Dear Jane Quilt Along 2019. We're still doing 2019.
Yeah, it's
yeah.
still 2019.
put us in there too, add Scrappy So and So. So, other than that, what else are we talking about tonight? We did get new Scrappy So and So shirts. So, our shirt
oh,
provider
yes.
has an embroidery special. They had an embroidery special in January. So, we ordered a prize for December's winner, who was...
WTF or something?
Yeah, and so she got a t-shirt with the embroidery, and then Melissa and I decided that we needed some more cozy sweats. So we decided mm-hmm. to go with the embroidered kangaroo pouch.
I love these.
Yeah, so it is nice and cozy. I got the black, Melissa got the white.
I just unpacked it today because I was like, I'll be too tempted to wear it and get coffee on it.
I wore mine the other day when I was sewing, and there's bits of thread on it. I don't know if it's visible in the video, but...
I wear my other
that's
one, like,
for.
All the time. My
yeah.
sister's at Christmas. I think I was wearing it, and my sister's like, you're wearing that again? Like, every time I see you, I'm like, it's comfortable.
So probably at another month later down the road, we'll do another prize with the t-shirts or something, right? I want to get a Scrappy So-and-So hat, because I wear a hat all the time when we walk, so... I would like to have a baseball cap with Scrappy So-and-So on it, so I might order those for us next. And then we can wear them while we're doing the video. That would be super cool. We would be cool.
You'd be like trucker hats with like the mesh on the back?
Yeah. I'm going to confess that I've actually done her okay.
Oh.
Because it was a lot of machine sewing.
I don't know if we can be friends anymore.
Yeah. I know, I just, you know, I get a little anxious, so I don't know what I'm going to do this month, but I'll do something. I still want to start my sashing, because I want to see what it looks like,
mm-hmm.
so maybe I'll do that this month, who knows.
I tried to start my sashing, but my blocks were all out of order, so now I put them all with their E and their...
I have all mine in the Ziploc baggie, but I don't know which row is which. I'd have to sit there and look at the quilt. There's going to be like 169
yeah.
just squares, right?
I thought, it'll be fine. Like, I'll figure it out. Because I had them all in like one tall. No, it was not. It was very confusing.
Yeah.
And some of them I was like, I don't. And it should follow with the color. I'm like, what the hell is this? And then one of them I'm not happy with. I think I'm going to redo it.
Yeah. I feel like when I was doing the Roquet, because there's a lot of machine sewing, and again with the Bonnie Hunter, like when I was doing the Bonnie Hunter quilt, I was doing like that nested seams, and I was totally conscious of which way I was pressing my seams this time. So I feel like my Roquet is going to be way better than like my Row A or Row B or whatever, right? Because, you know, we're getting better at it. Which is nice. And then I think, well, maybe I should redo them, but then I think no, because then when I look at the quilt, I'm going to see the growth that occurred in 18 months, right?
That's
but
right.
But, like, the triangles are the ones that are making me lose sleep, honestly. They're the ones that are scaring
me a little
bit.
I feel
like
they're going to be bigger, so it's not going to be as hard.
Well, see, the thing is that I've been using the computer program, the Dear Jane, EQ Dear Jane.
Mm-hmm.
And I know there's a few of you out there that are using it, too. So I have a question for that, because I tried to print the triangles, and I cannot figure out what size they're supposed to print at. And I just wanted to print the block to some degree just so then I could cut out the EPP paper piecing, because most of it's either embroidery. There's some quilting, like machine, sorry, not quilting, machine piecing, which I can figure out. It's not tough by measuring the blocks, but it wouldn't print the right size. I kept adjusting and then measuring and adjusting, and it just, I could not get it to print. So if you've used the program, I think Pat, I don't know if Pat's used the program. I know you've done a Dear Jane, so if you could maybe in the comments, because you always comment, I know I can count on you. If you could tell me how you print those triangles that are not the triangles, it's the corner diamond. It's the triangles are fine. I figured out the size of the triangles, but it's
the corner triangles,
the corner diamonds or whatever they are. Those are the ones I can't print. They're really messing me up. So it'd be nice to be able to print them at the right size, but at the moment I haven't been able to do it. So I'd appreciate any help that you can give me. SOS. Dear Jane emergency.
Please, Pat, help her.
Please, Pat, be my friend.
Oh, God.
But yeah, other than that, I think that's pretty much it for our video. It's a pretty short and sweet one, unless there's something else you want to add.
No. Don't let me ramble. I'm tired.
Oh, I'm already
starting. Come out.
I like crazy Melissa. But yeah, so happy birthday to you this week.
Thank you.
Your birthday week.
Birthday
so
week.
It's special.
Yeah.
She's a whole year younger than, well, not quite a whole year, but almost a year younger than I am, so I'm a little jealous.
Oh, don't be jealous. I look like I'm 5 years older than you.
Yo, whatever. You'll never look like you're 5 years older.
There's a strike, right? The education strike. So
yeah.
I don't know why, but Blake comes home the other day and he's like, Mom, I only have 2 days of school this week. I'm like, how is that possible? They didn't email me, but I think, and Bob's like, no, it's some, it must be like the another one of the unions that are in the school. Anyways, he had school today, not tomorrow, Wednesday, not Thursday or Friday. So I was like, Blake, spa day with Mom on Thursday. It's my birthday. We do what I want.
Yeah, exactly. So that'll be nice. Now you got some, you guys can use those face things.
Oh, yeah. I was like, we'll go get our eyebrows done. He's like,
see, Hazel would be all over that, but
yeah. When you only have a 9-year-old boy.
Yeah.
I don't know. He'll do something. Or we won't get our eyebrows done.
What do you do, like threading?
No, I don't usually do that at all, but I want to do the threading. I want to try the threading, but it's in one of those kiosks in the middle of the mall.
Yeah, that's what I've had that done there.
Like, I just
close your eyes and pretend you're somewhere else.
Too self-conscious to, like,
see, I got my eyebrows waxed once and the girl burned me, so I will never ever do waxing again. Not that I really have a lot of eyebrows, I have to draw on parts because
thank you,
missing.
the 90s.
But yeah, I like the threading, and if I am at Cambridge Center Mall, which I was planning on going yesterday when we were supposed to come here, I usually go and get my eyebrows threaded.
It's like, they look really nice.
I don't know how they do it without hurting their necks. I would have a stiff neck.
But I don't know.
But yeah, now we're rambling. So we're going to sign off tonight. Yeah, cut it off. And we will see you again probably in about another month, right? When we talk about we're okay. All right.
Bye.
Happy sewing.
This one has this funny way that she says hello. She's like, hello, my name is Christina, and welcome to my channel.
Do you want to do that?
Bob was like, do you think you could get you and Eve to do it at the same time like that?
Hello, we're Scrappy.
it's really funny the way that she does this thing, and then she goes, if you are a returning subscriber.
I'm totally putting it in the video.
Y'all already know. Y'all are my babies. So she does. And it's hilarious and it makes me laugh every single time.